Despite the hazards, as time went on, living on the bottom of the ocean began to feel almost routine. The longer the Sealab II aquanauts stayed submerged, the more media attention they generated. Never one to miss a good chance for publicity, George Bond arranged for Scott Carpenter to receive a call from President Lyndon Johnson.
Scott, I'm mighty glad to hear from you. You've convinced me and all the nation that whether you're going up or down, you have the courage and the skill to do a fine job.
Well, thank you very much. A great crew out there. And we're all very honored and pleased with
this. When Sealab II was raised to the surface on October 11th, 1965, it had been manned continuously for 45 days, including Carpenter's record stay of 30 days below.
The crew of Sealab II's mothership manned the decompression chamber. After Aquanaut, Scott Carpenter and his men returned to the surface. Everybody appears hale and hearty after their life 200 feet below the surface. At a later press conference, all of the Aquanauts are elated over their accomplishments. The Navy feels that men have proven that man can readily adapt himself to the strange environment of the sea with little or no ill effects. Carpenter, the second American to orbit the Earth, points out his living quarters to his wife. Now he's the only man to hold records in the sky above and in the sea below.